Austin City Limits presents one of the most inspiring new young pop singers in years, Olivia Rodrigo. Songs that mix pain with joy from Phoebe Bridgers. Recorded live from the Moody Theater, it's Austin City Limits. Now, combining sensitivity and boldness with an original voice, Olivia Rodrigo.
I'm so insecure, I think that I'll die before I drink. I'm so caught up in the news of who likes me and who hates you. I'm so tired that I might quit my job, start a new life. And they'd all be so disappointed, cause who am I if not exploited? And I'm so sick of 17, where's my teenage dream? Someone tells me one more time, enjoy your youth, I'm gonna cry. And I don't stick up for myself, I'm anxious and nothing can help. And I wish I'd done this before, and I wish people liked me more. Wreck, cause I love people I don't like, and I hate every song I write, and I'm not cool, and I'm not smart, and I can't even tell apart. All I did was try my best, it's the kind of things I get, I'm relentlessly upset. This day is all the golden years, but I wish I could disappear, ego crushes so severe, God's in!
Happy, but don't be happier.
do you tell her she's the most beautiful girl you've ever seen? An eternal love bolt, you know you'll never meet. Remember when I believed you meant it when you said it first to me. She's beautiful, she looks kind. She probably gives you butterflies. I hope you're happy, just not like how you were with me. I'm selfish, I know, I can't let you go to find someone.
Olivia, it's so cool to be here today. Thank you so much for having me. This is my first time in Austin, and I'm having the best time, and obviously I'm with the best company.
I kinda wanna throw my phone across the room, 'cause all I see are girls too good to be true. Paper white teeth and perfect bodies. Wish I didn't care. I know their beauty's not my like, but it feels like that weight is on my back, and I can't let it go. Quick comparison. Jealousy, jealousy.
This is the first song I ever put out, and it's really special to me. So sing along if you know it. This is Driver's License.
Driver's license last week, just like we always talked about. Cause you were so excited for me to finally drive up to your house. But today I drove through the suburbs crying cause you weren't around. And you're probably with that blonde girl who always made me doubt. So much older than me, she's everything I'm insecure about. Yet today I drove through the suburbs, cause how could I ever love someone else? And I know we weren't perfect, but I've never felt this way for no one. And I just can't imagine how. Forever now I drive alone past your street, and all my friends are tired of hearing how much I miss you. But I kind of feel sorry for them, cause they'll never know you the way that I do. Yet today I drove through the suburbs, pictured I was driving.
Second that we called it quits.
to shut me down, show her off like she's a new trophy. I know if you were true, there's no damn way that you could fall in love with somebody that quickly. Ain't it funny? All the twisted games, all the questions you used to avoid. Ain't it funny? Remember I brought her up and you told me I was paranoid. You betrayed me, and I know that you'll never feel sorry for the way I hurt. Yeah, how you talked to her when we were together, loved you at your worst, but that didn't matter. It took you 2 weeks to go off and date her. Guess you didn't cheat, but you're still a traitor. God, I wish that you had thought this through. God, I wish that you had thought this through before I went and fell in love with you. Now that I loved you so bad, I let you treat me like that. I was your willing accomplice, honey. I watched as you fled the scene. Though it is you buried me, one heart broke, four hands bloody. The things I did just so I could call you mine. The things you did, well, I hope I was your favorite crime. Use me as an alibi. I crossed my heart as you crossed the line, and I defended you to all my friends. And now every time the siren sounds, I wonder if you're around, 'cause you know that I'd do it all again. All the things I did just so I could call you mine. The things you did, well, I hope I was your favorite crime. It's bittersweet to think about the damage that we do, 'cause I was going down but I was doing it with you. Yeah, everything we broke and all the trouble that we made, but I say that I hate you with a smile on my face. I wrote it on my bedroom floor. Actually, looking in a mirror, which is kind of like weirdly metaphorical, and I didn't mean it that way, but when I wrote it, I always felt like this inferiority with people. Like, I always felt like I wasn't pretty enough or good enough or smart enough to be in somebody's life. And one of the awesome parts of growing up for me was realizing that, you know, when you're in a relationship with someone, platonic or romantic or whatever, usually when someone makes you feel like you're not good enough, it's because they don't feel like they're good enough themselves. And that was a really cool thing for me to learn growing up. And I wrote a song about it, and it's called Enough For You.
I thought she'd like me more. If I looked like the other prom queens I know that she loved before. Tried so hard to be everything that she liked, just for you to say you're not the compliment type. And I knew how you took your coffee and your favorite songs by heart. I read all of your self-help books so you'd think that I was smart. Stupid, emotional, obsessive little me. I knew from the start this is exactly how you'd leave. You found someone more exciting the next second you were gone. And you left me there crying, wondering what I did wrong. And you always say I'm never satisfied, but I don't think that's true. 'Cause all I ever wanted was to be enough for you. Yeah, all I ever wanted was to be enough for you. Maybe I'm just not as interesting as the girls you had before. But God, you couldn't have cared less about someone who loved you more. I'd say you broke my heart, but you broke much more than that. Now I don't want your sympathy, I just want myself back. Before you found someone more exciting, the next second you were gone. And you left me there crying, wondering what I did wrong. And you always say I'm never satisfied, but I don't think that's true. 'Cause all I ever wanted was to be enough. And don't you think I loved you too much to be used and discarded? Don't you think I loved you too much to think I deserve nothing? But don't tell me you're sorry, boy. Feel sorry for yourself. 'Cause someday I'll be everything to somebody else. They'll think that I'm so exciting, and you'll be the one who's crying. Yeah, you always say I'm never satisfied, but I don't think that's true. You say I'm never satisfied, but that's not me, it's you. 'Cause all I ever wanted was to be enough. But I don't think anything could ever be enough for you. Enough for you. Oh, no, nothing's enough for you. You moved on really easily. You found a new girl and it only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? And good for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. I guess the therapist I found for you, she really helped. Now you can be a better man for your brand new girl.
Good for you, you look happy and healthy. Not if you ever cared to ask. Good for you.
Guess you're getting everything you want. You bought a new car and your career's really taking off. It's like we never even happened, baby. What the f*** is up with that? And good for you, it's like you never even met me. Remember when you swore to God I was the only person who ever got you? Well, screw that, screw you. Too emotional. Maybe you never cared. Maybe I'm too emotional. Your apathy's like a wound insult. Maybe I'm too emotional. Maybe you never cared at all. But good for you, you look happy and healthy. Not me, if you ever care to ask. Good for you, you're doing great out there without me. Guess you moved out really easily. Thank you, guys. Thank you, guys, for real. You have been the best crowd. Thank you. I'm a very nervous person. Like, I get nervous before I take math tests. So, like, performing in front of thousands of people is definitely a little bit nerve-wracking sometimes, but it's so exhilarating. It's just so cool to connect with people on, like, a real human level and, you know, not through, like, social media, which is lovely too, but it's just a whole new experience when you're in person feeling the songs with people. It's incredible. You know, I think social media is really wonderful in some regards. I've used it to connect with fans and that's been incredible and such an enriching experience. But, you know, sometimes I think everyone has to check in with themselves and check in on their mental health, and sometimes social media can kind of be tricky in that regard. I love listening to sad songs. I love writing sad songs. I just love music that really moves you. I love music that makes you feel, you know, different after you listen to it, like this sort of catharsis. And I've been writing like sad breakup songs since I was like 10 years old, like before I had even like held hands with the boy. It's just sort of been something that's always been in me. And so it's, yeah, super cool to see those songs sort of resonate with people too. I remember putting Driver's License out, which is this really like heartfelt breakup ballad, and watching so many people resonate with it. People would come up to me, you know, older men, people of different sexualities and genders and ages. And that was really cool for me to see. And even people who, you know, had been married for 30 years, they'd come up to me and they'd be like, oh, I'm not like feeling that way, but it takes me back to when I was 17 years old and I was going through my first heartbreak. And I think that's super magical that music not only has the power to unite us all in that feeling, but also transport people back to a time when they were feeling the same way that I was feeling. It's just magic. There's no other way to describe it. I've always been writing songs, even if they're gibberish, and I was 4 years old, but it wasn't until I was about 9 years old that I learned how to play piano, and that's when my love for songwriting kind of really skyrocketed, and I learned more about the craft of it all. It's just been amazing ever since.